What's up? Today we got back day, vertical pull emphasis. So we're gonna go ahead and get some skill work on some pull-ups, some heavy-weighted pull-ups. Push into some Nautilus lat pull down.
You say leg day?
Nah, back day.
I swear I heard you say leg day.
No. Staying away from legs today.
Back day.
So we got back day. Like I said, heavy-weighted pull-ups. We'll go Nautilus lat pull down. Chest supported row.
Yeah.
And then go into some isolated back stuff. So either some posterior delts and biceps. So we got skill, output, iso.
Kind of getting into like a shoulder warm up. I'll give like a really complicated or a more extravagant shoulder explanation than then kind of like a very simple one. But with the shoulder, I like to go like an inside out approach. I adopted this from the muscle doc, Jordan Shallow's shoulder approach, but going inside out, think T-spine, shoulder blade, rotator cuff, and then internal rotators. So T-spine, can we rotate? Are we stuck in flexion? Are we stuck in extension? Do we need to free up mobility there? The scap, are we able to fully protract, fully retract our scap? Rotator cuff, are we able to stabilize overhead, and also are we able to get adequate external rotation? And then internal rotation would be inhibiting internal rotator, so making sure if our pecs are tight, stretch our pecs a little bit, if our lats are tight, stretch our lats a little bit. So looking at those four different doors, kind of assessing where we have issues, we can more specifically address those issues head on into a warm-up. All right, so another way we look at the shoulder, so we can look at kind of breaking it down, or warm-ups that is, as like passive, active, static, active, dynamic. So going with passive, we're gonna have Joey doing a external rotation stretch. You do a band, you do a cable. Basically what we're trying to do is have him get passively pulled into ER at the shoulder. That'd be like our A1 for our B1. So we just did passive, now we're gonna go active, static. So we're gonna have him hold external rotation overhead with high cable curl. All right, so we went passive, free up some range of motion. Now we're gonna reinforce that. So he's maintaining ER right here. He's doing a cable curl, but statically maintaining external rotation. So they pick our A2. And then for A3, we can actually reinforce external rotation, actively actually training external rotation at the shoulder. So we went passive, active static, build awareness around the position, and then active dynamic, actually training through the position. And then with our A4, if we're gonna do like an integrated warm up, we can actually do whatever our exercise is for the day, which today was a pull up. Pull ups are gonna be our main like skill exercise right now. So we're kind of going skill with the pull ups, getting into loading them heavy, and then we're gonna go on the Nautilus pull down over here for more output. So we're training that closer to failure. Training this more just for proficiency, and also just getting a heavy overhead pull. Generally, like pull ups are a pretty good check on shoulder function, or a pretty good expression of shoulder function. So if your shoulders are feeling iffy, usually I recommend, as a blanket statement, is doing pull-ups, but getting full upper rotation of the scap, making sure our rotator cuff can stabilize overhead, making sure our teres can set our shoulder. Checks a lot of boxes at the shoulder, so if pull-ups hurt or if pull-ups are uncomfortable, there's probably a greater issue there. I like keeping something in that has a long runway for progression, so you can keep this in for a long time and still easily progress it, whether that's going body weight, adding reps, if you're very good at pull-ups, starting to add load. You can keep pull-ups in for a long time. So instead of having like a, you know, an 8-week progression, maybe we can milk out like a 16, 20, 24-week progression out of it. Nice, nice. One more.
Yep. So between the different handles too, so Nixon, more of a pronated grip. If you are having struggles with your shoulder but still want to get into some of these exercises like a lat pull down or a pull up, you can change the grip into more of a neutral grip or a supinated grip. It's gonna bice the lat a little bit more, and it's gonna put you already into an externally rotated position, so it can take some of the stress off the shoulder. For both of us, we are trying to get more external rotation. If it hurts or if it's just an awkward position for you, you can't find that rhythm, go ahead and almost just kind of rotate the arm.
Come on, four. Yeah, two more. Five. Come on.
See, if you can't get into any pull-ups, we can use lat pull-down, or we can use a lat pull-down machine. Still weight it. It gives us obviously the same stimulus, but This is gonna be a little bit more of a relative strength exercise.
All right, so we just went skill, over on the pull-ups. Pull-ups are gonna kind of train like generally our entire back, so we're getting some lats out of it. We're getting some rotator cuff out of it. We're getting some rhomboids out of it. Kind of training everything here or there. Here, we're gonna go more of like an isolated approach on the lats. We're trying to bias our lats the most. So more external stability from our environment here. Really good setup for training our lats to failure.
Machines like this, we can cue setup pretty heavily. And then once we find our setup, we can really just focus on output. We don't have to worry about arm position, arm path, where we're feeling it, all that stuff. The machine kind of sets us in the position correctly, and then we can just go ahead and pull. So now we're gonna load it, get into a rep range about 8 to 10. Should be working about 2 to 3 working sets, get into a relative failure on it.
Good. Come on. Yep, 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 yep. Good.
That's way too light for you, bro. Way too light for you. Our pull-up was a skill-based exercise. We're trying to get better at this skill. So we're gonna work to more of a technical failure on this Nautilus lat pull-down, or if you have a single arm cable lat pull-down, even if you go over to a cable stack and work like a half-kneeling cable lat pull-down. We're working output now. So now we're getting into like a muscular fatigue. And once we hit like fatigue, then we're gonna go ahead and cut it there. So one's gonna be more like technical-based. If you start losing your ability to externally rotate, pull correctly, we're gonna go ahead and cut it there. On these exercises, we're gonna get like, because it's a lot more simplistic movement, we're really gonna work to, you can add a couple of more uglier reps into it because of how simplistic the movement is. You're not gonna really hurt yourself on it, but we wanna get into like true like muscular failure. So even a couple half reps, you see bodybuilders do like partial reps, they're still getting the contraction of the muscle. It's not gonna be through 4 inches of motion, but they're really trying to exhaust kind of all the muscle fibers in that muscle. So
nice. Give me 8. One more. Let's go. Stay tight. Come on.
When Nick's doing this exercise too, when he's leaning into it, he's not bending at his side, like getting into an awkward position. He's pushing in so that his arm path is a straight pull down. So there's no deviation between his wrist pulling, his elbow pulling, and his shoulder pulling. If he stands too vertical, when we get up on the rep, we end up reaching. And we put a lot of stress on that shoulder. And when we rotate into it, we're taking leverage off that lat.
Our lats don't really pull us into lateral flexion, right? Like just the idea that we should like bend as we extend our shoulder. It's not really gonna be beneficial for the lat. So what I'm doing here with the bend is like, I'm not like bending as I go. I'm only bending a little bit, just like Joey said, get myself into this neutral arm path. So that way it's just purely shoulder extension, what our lats are gonna do, versus like me bending into it. So I'm just getting there, getting my setup good, going straight through shoulder extension.
So we went pull up, bit of lat pull down variation. So depending on what your gym has, most gyms are gonna have something that you can do pull ups on, but if you can't do a pull up, switch it out for a lat pull down. The next exercise, you can go with a, if your lat pull downs have the dual handle, unilateral kind of cable system, you can go ahead and load one of them. Then for this, we have a chest supported row. So any T-bar row variation, you can do dumbbell on a bench, incline row, anything where your chest is supported, we're gonna be working more mid-thoracic. So your mid-trap, rhomboids,
my Joey Slye bingo is mid-thoracic.
Mid-thoracic, everybody drink a protein shake. shot of a pre-workout.
God damn, dude. Maybe we should train 5 days. Change our split to have an arm day.
Kicking is a recovery day for me right now. So rep range on this is gonna be, because this is our third exercise, is gonna be our second output exercise. Our rep range is gonna be a little bit lower. So try to stay anywhere between like 6 to 8. On the single arm lat pull down, we did 8 to 10. This one we wanna get a little more weight on it, but the volume is gonna start accumulating during your workout. So let's dumb this down to about 6 to 8. Obviously, if you're still getting to 8 to 10, go ahead, cut it, throw a little bit more weight on there, and get into a little bit lower rep range.
All the way back. Let's go. Good.
A lot of people start talking about like kind of CNS fatigue. Me and Nick kind of have this conversation a lot, but we're not feeling like CNS fatigue is going to be coming from loading yourself super heavily. That's really not going to accumulate a lot of CNS fatigue. We get more fatigue from a very, very high volume day. And almost like a lot of dumb reps on your body, it's almost gonna just inhibit most of your exercises later on during the week because of how much like volume fatigue that you've had over.
You're being calculated with your sets. Yeah. So Joey's not coming on here and doing like a set of 20 with 2 plates and then a set of 15 with 3 plates and then a set of 12 with 4 plates and then finally getting to his working set for 5 plates and doing his 2 top sets there. Kind of like, we know he's gonna be somewhere between 4 and 5 plates. So we're spending as little energy as possible as we can getting to that point, and then we're getting to that point, sending it for a few sets, getting on to the next thing. Fatigue is more from like, one, I would say doing too much volume, two, like the kind of weight we're moving. So if we're getting a lot of like maximal core contraction from a lot of like barbell lifts, like that's gonna be pretty fatiguing. And then also like a high amount of volume from other work. So that could be machines like this, could be from isolation work, probably not from doing too many bicep curls. We got a lot of rear delts out of our upper back row over there. We're kind of trying to finish it off with a little more isolation. So we've talked about it countless times with our push tape videos, but it kind of the way we go about it is like loaded, isolated. So if we're trying to get a lot of rear delt work, we're gonna get a lot of rear delt out of loading it in a compound movement like that strive row. If we want to kind of finish it off, be more precise with it, we'll do some rear delt flies right here.
We're doing these, we call them T-raises, you know, like posterior delt flies, whatever it might be, grab an incline bench. Make sure that we're, get that upper chest kind of off the bench. It's gonna help us stay in a little bit more protracted state.
More like abduction as opposed to abduction and retraction. Yeah. That's exactly what we got on the row over there. So it's like that was more compound in nature. We want this more isolated in nature. So we don't really care about like the back portion of that.
Yeah.
We're just trying to get straight rear delt.
And with this too, when we're using it on that incline row and that incline supported chest row, it's a little bit more to stabilize the shoulder while we're going through extension. And so it's working more as the secondary muscle in that action. It's not really the primary mover. So you might have a really strong back, but if the supporting muscles around that shoulder aren't strong, you can have a lack of stability in that. And so the movements can cause issues. So the stronger that you get up in those weights, the more your technical ability breaks down, which is why you can't load it as well. So these are gonna help you to be able to load some of those output machines to get stronger in those movements.
So just finishing up main bicep movement for the day, it's just gonna be dumbbell curls, loading the bicep, I think it's easy. You see all these variations on the internet of all these like different high cable, low cable curls, you know, fucking long head, bicep, short head. Don't worry about that shit unless you're already huge. Like, you're gonna get the most stimulus from just loading it. So that doesn't mean throwing it around. Joey's not slinging the shit around. It's still slow and controlled, but doing a modality that we can load. 50s.
Not bad. So we started off our skill exercise for today again was our pull-ups. If you can't do a pull-up, start on the lat pull-down machine. Get into a rep range that you feel like you're working the skill of the movement. Then we're going to a single arm lat pull-down. And if you don't have a Nautilus machine like that or any machine like a hammer strength like that in your gym, you can go ahead and use a single arm cable lat pull-down. Going into our chest supporter row, find an incline bench, dumbbells if you don't have a machine like that in your gym. And then finishing up with some posterior delts, so some T-raises and some bicep curls. We got skill, output, iso. The way you kind of structure your programs like that, it's gonna help you to get better at certain exercises that you wanna progress on. It's gonna load it so we can get some hypertrophy of the muscle and then get into some isolated exercises. Throw this on your back workout, throw this video on while you're walking and get a good little idea of what you wanna do in the weight room. If you got any questions, throw them in the comments. This YouTube video, we're gonna try to start getting into a little bit more answering questions on there. Might dive a little bit more in depth if you guys have any specific questions. So go ahead and throw them on the bottom of the YouTube page. Me and Nick will get to them as we can. So appreciate you guys. Peace.